Once upon a time in the ancient lands of Egypt, there was a powerful and radiant god named Ra. He was not just any god, but the god of the sun, the creator of all life, and the ruler of the heavens, the earth, and the underworld. Ra's power was absolute, and his presence in the sky represented life, warmth, and growth for the Egyptian people. Ra's story begins at the dawn of time, when the universe was nothing but endless chaos. From the primordial waters of Nun, Ra emerged, bringing light to the world for the first time. With his mere words, he created the earth, the sky, and all living beings. As the god of the sun, Ra was responsible for bringing light to the world every day. Each morning, he would climb into his great solar bark, the bark of millions of years, and sail across the sky, lighting up the land of Egypt with his golden rays. But Ra's journey didn't end at sunset. As the day faded into night, Ra's bark would descend into the Duat, the Egyptian underworld. Here, the sun god faced his greatest challenge. The underworld was filled with danger and chaos, ruled by the monstrous serpent Apophis, a being that embodied darkness and disorder. Every night, Apophis would rise from the depths, determined to swallow Ra's bark and extinguish the light forever. But Ra, with the help of other gods like Seth and Horus, fought fiercely against Apophis. Their battles were intense, filled with thunder and flashes of light, and yet, every night, Ra emerged victorious. At dawn, he would rise again, bringing a new day to the world. This daily cycle of light and darkness, life and death, was at the heart of Egyptian belief. Ra's journey across the sky and through the underworld symbolized the eternal cycle of creation, destruction, and rebirth. Just as the sun was reborn each day, so too did the Egyptians believe that life continued after death in the afterlife. But Ra's influence didn't stop at just being the sun god. Over time, he merged with other powerful deities, further cementing his status as the supreme god. In the city of Heliopolis, Ra became known as Amun-Ra, the fusion of Ra and the hidden god, Amun, symbolizing Ra's supreme authority over all the gods. As Ra-Horakhti, he was combined with Horus, the falcon-headed god, representing the rising sun and the promise of new beginnings. In his form as Atum-Ra, he embodied the sun's full cycle from sunrise to sunset, symbolizing the natural flow of life, aging, and death. Ra was deeply connected to the pharaohs of Egypt, who were considered his earthly representatives. The pharaohs were often called the sons of Ra, and it was believed that Ra bestowed divine authority upon them to rule over Egypt. Every time a new pharaoh ascended the throne, it was seen as a continuation of Ra's divine rule on earth. The Egyptians honored Ra through massive temples, like the one at Heliopolis, and through the construction of obelisks, tall stone monuments that represented the rays of the sun and Ra's eternal power. As Ra's influence continued to grow, so too did his myths. One such story tells of a time when Ra's power began to wane as he grew older. Humanity, seeing that their god had aged, started to rebel against him. Enraged by their disobedience, Ra sent Sekhmet, the fierce lioness goddess, to punish them. But Sekhmet's fury was so great that she nearly destroyed all of humanity. To save them, Ra tricked Sekhmet by flooding the land with red-colored beer, which she mistook for blood. She drank it and, intoxicated, fell asleep, sparing humanity from her wrath. After this, Ra decided it was time to withdraw from the earth. He handed over the reign of the world to Osiris and the other gods and retreated into the heavens, where he continued his daily journey across the sky. Though Ra no longer ruled directly, his presence was still felt every day when the sun rose in the sky, a reminder of his eternal guardianship over the world. Ra's story is one of creation, resilience, and the balance of the cosmos. His daily battle with Apophis symbolized the triumph of light over darkness. and his retreat into the heavens showed the wisdom of a god who understood the natural cycles of life. Even though Ra handed over the rule to other gods, his legacy lived on in the rising sun, the temples dedicated to him, and the power he bestowed upon Egypt's pharaohs. And so, the ancient Egyptians continued to worship Ra, believing in his power to bring light and life to their world. His presence could be seen in the towering obelisks that pointed toward the sky, in the rituals performed by the priests, and in the stories passed down through generations. Ra was more than just a god. He was the very essence of life itself, the eternal light that never faded, and the guiding force that kept the universe in perfect balance.